Hello, YouTube. Oh. Hello. Right. I'm going to try and show you how to make a sort of Brookes Brothers-y beat. I don't know if you saw my how to make a Xylent drop really quickly, but I'm using the same drums from that. It's it's Total Samples, Total Dubstep Volume 4. The drums are amazing. Like, I'll show you. I haven't even had to EQ them, and they're already sounding pretty good. Well, I did EQ the kick a bit, because it was a bit flabby, but I'm going to show you how I root my drums and shit as well. But you shouldn't listen to my advice here, because the way I do stuff's a bit anal. So, that's the snare. I haven't EQ'd it. There isn't an EQ, a compressor, or anything on it. And what I do is I've routed the snare to the channel next to it, and I do that just in case I want another snare to layer on the top, so I can put it in this channel and then route that to there. And then I send it all over here to this one. And I do that with my kick as well, so the kick's next to it, just so I can play the beat. And I can see the kick and snare volume next to each other. I just do it for more control, but you don't have to worry about that at all. So here's my beat. Even with the rides, all I've used is two rides and a snare. No, a hi-hat, that's it. I haven't EQ'd any of them. They're just in the mix, fine. Sounding beautiful. Okay, so yeah, I'm going to try and show you how to do like a Brookes Brothers-y thing from like what they used to make a few years ago. I really liked their sound then. I still like their sound anyway, so whatever. I found these noises in this Vengeance Essential House Pack, and some of them sound quite cool, like funky, like Brookes Brothers-y. That's the one I want. So, drag it in. This is a cool thing about Fruity Loops. Like, it's so easy just to get stuff in time. Like, all I do is click on this time stretching bit, click on auto. That means it keeps it in key no matter how you stretch it. And as long as you know how many bars your loop is, you can just like put it in. So if I do that, that's what we're going for. If that makes any sense. Sorry if it... So that's in time. And what I do with a sound like this, I use a lot of sounds over my tunes just to layer them over really gently. Like, so they're just kind of in the back of the mix sort of thing. And I've already made the channel for it. All I do is, well, I compress it a lot. All I fuck about with is the ratio, the threshold, and the gain. And like compressing stuff a lot just makes it sound like it has more space in the mix. So that's what this will sound like now. It's the other good thing about Fruity Loops. I mean, I'm sure a few of you use it already, so sorry if I'm teaching you stuff you already know. But, like this bit here, like, I just chopped up the loop, and then you can use this tool. The bit I've just chopped up, you can just drag it and just move it about and just find a new bit, so I'll add a different rhythm. That wasn't very different. Getting a new loop. These kind of sounded the same, so I thought they'd work. Oh, the end looks good on this one. The other good thing about Fruity Loops, you can just drag the front or the back of your sample just to move it about. I need to route that to the same compressor. sub bass time. Right, empty thing. Oh yeah, sorry, right. The sound, the guitar-y thing that I've got, it's going to my sidechain channel. And I sidechain like every noise in my tunes, my kick and my snare. And I sidechain it by half. That's it. So you'll see how much it's doing it by here. You can see it going down by half, roughly. So if I do it more, it just sounds... I do it more with dubstep, because it sounds better in dubstep. Like drum and bass, it sounds not quite right. Well, I did watch that Brookes Brothers tutorial, and they sidechained fucking a lot. But it sounded good for them, so, you know, whatever. I'm just going to grab one more noise. Need a G-sharp noise. That's the noise. Ultimate. I might not sidechain this noise though, because it's quite light. There's not too much going on. Right, sub bass. I've already got it in the project. It's all I normally use is just this sine wave that I bounced ages ago. It's just that. I don't do anything to it apart from send it to the sidechain channel. Like, that's it. I put Maximus on there, but it's not even turned on at the moment. Maximus is just makes everything a bit louder, but it doesn't need to be loud. It's already loud, I hope. Okay, let's make a quick rhythm. It's all about the spaces in your bass. The gaps in your bass can make the tune good. And everyone likes a dippy doo, so I'm gonna do that, I guess. I hope you guys don't think this sounds shit, because I've never used these drums for drum and bass before. What I normally do with most tunes like this, I layer a Reese on the bottom of everything really quietly. The Reese I'm using in this one, I haven't added it yet, but that's all it is. You can copy the preset if you want. I'm not going to teach you how to make that right now. But there you go, voice. That's all you really need to see. Osc, routing. There you go. Just pause it and copy it if you want. Oh, better show you the mod oscs as well. Phase, position, there you go. Now you can copy it. Copy, paste. We'll be right back. tape. I was just getting on a roll with that. I thought I got the best screenshot program in the world, and it was working really well. And then it's like after 3 days, it said you can now only record for 10 minutes. Dick. So yeah, hope you enjoyed that. Hope you learnt something. Bye.